get a mid-range shot, not a long-range shot, and Gianni LaWalle is on the bench.
He is, and Bell and Shumpert are the guards. Udofi is on the bench. Reaching foul on Booker. Three on Trevor Booker.
At a time when you need to play position defense, and the position defense was pretty good, but for the reach. You want to take the lane away. You want Peacock to pick up the ball. They're in pretty good shape right there until the reach. Actually, Grant created more problems as far as the contact than did Booker. But nevertheless, each one of them reaching, that's what got him in trouble.
Yeah, one of them was going to be called for.
But you know what? The way Georgia Tech's been shooting free throws, Brunson has a chance to win this game.
The way everybody has, although Peacock is a really good free throw shooter. 84% on the season. He had missed his first opportunity tonight. He makes that.
Well, remember, Zachary Peacock, he's solid. The senior, Paul Hewitt doesn't mind calling on him. Called on him to handle on that situation against Carolina. He got the shot, the go-ahead shot that ultimately won the game.
Got the roll.
So he's the foundation. He's the guy that Paul Hewitt leans on. And he seems to deliver more times than not.
With those two free throws, Georgia Tech 11 out of 22 from the free throw line. Nobody with any timeouts left. And Georgia Tech will have 3.2 seconds to get off the shot. But with 3.2 seconds, one pass gets you off a good shot.
Oh, it certainly does, but... You know, throughout this game, it's been about Georgia Tech's big fellas working hard and getting rewarded, whether it's getting good position down low, being a beneficiary of some nice inside passing, or playing above the rim. Both Favors and Gianni LaWalle have been as active as any two front line players I've seen this year. Not only from an active, but they've been successful.
They have been sensational. Two to go.
No timeouts. You may have a chance for one quick pass.
Stitt will inbound with a big guy on him. Favors going to make it tougher to throw it in.
I think Grant receives. He may want to drop it off to Stitt, and he's going to have to take a long one. He got about two dribbles.
Loose ball. That's it. Georgia Tech survives a challenge at home. And how ironic that a couple of free throws would decide it the way these guys have shot free throws.
Well, you take a look at